Well, hi everybody. This is a bit of a different video today. I'm joined by Colin, and Colin's motorcycle is in for service. He's got a 500 Bullet, a three-year-old bike now, and it's in for its 3,000-mile service. So Bike Treads have kindly loaned him a Meteor 350 to take out for the day. So I'll let Colin introduce the video.
I'm sure you recognise me. I usually ride the vintage motorcycles. You've seen my 103-year-old Royal Enfield before and some of the other old bikes we've been on. But as Sandy has said, we're taking out the 350 today. And I'd like to compare this one to the 500 Classic, just to see what the differences are. Apparently this one's got a lot smoother engine. There's a lot of other improvements. And we can report back and let you know our findings.
Well, that's it. We're just getting ourselves ready to go for our ride. What I have noticed, the engine makes a wonderful sound at tick over. Lovely thud thud sound. Not a lot of engine rattly noises, something like that. So there we are at the petrol station. Colin's fueling up. Petrol cap obviously stays connected to the tank, which is convenient. Runs on E5 and E10 unleaded petrol. Well, it has to be said that I'm a bit late to the show with regarding a review of the Royal Enfield 350 Meteor. But then I've also got to say that I'm not a... I don't really sort of... I wouldn't consider myself to be a motorcycle review channel, shall we say. It's only that we had the chance to take this bike out because Colin's in for a service that we thought we'd do a quick video on it. But so far, first impressions of the bike are very good. One thing I have noticed about the bike, riding behind it, you'll see in a minute, the bar end mirrors are in a very, very good position. There's no arms in the way. Let's let Colin get in front and you'll see that. Well, we just stopped off at the Three Trees cafe on the Swindon to Marlborough Road. There it is there, look, the busy road. But anyone in the area, this is a lovely place to stop. The food here is really nice. It's all organic and locally sourced. Anyway, we're now going to go onwards for a nice rural ride. Yeah, I just spotted out of the corner of my eye this bank of electric chargers, look. I wonder what you think of the electric revolution. Well, we're riding now just on the north banks of what is the Lyddington Castle, Lyddington Hill Fort. There it is, just up there. One of the Iron Age hill forts in the area. This is a lovely temperature to ride in. It's not too hot and it's not too cold, and the sun isn't out blinding you. So ideal riding for me. We're just heading towards Bishopston, which is a lovely little village. It's got a nice pond. We get some idea off of Colin how is he getting on with that bike. Unfortunately, I'm not able to ride it because I didn't bring my driving license to get clearance for the insurance. So you know, I'd have to get Colin's perspective on it. So Bishopston is a lovely little village, and I say it's got a pond. And I don't think Colin's going to stop at the pond. So that, there's the pond, look. A pond for a village was a very important thing. Years and years ago, it was a place where cattle could be watered, where fish could be reared, clothes could be washed. Obviously, I'm going back few hundred years when people would have used it for that. but it would have been a place where the community gathered, very much a focal point of the village. Now, of course, it's just an ornamental thing. That little bike pulls quite hard, you know. It's lower gear. It's more, I say, it's more eager. It pulls harder than my Himalayan. So we're now coming down into the Lambourne Valley. It's a lovely, lovely road. Sweep, nice long sweeping bends. It's a nice valley area. With shadow belts of trees and the folds of the chalk downlands, you can just see that now. A wood on the right hand side, which is all part of the Ashdown estate. And this little corner here, this is known as Honeybunch Corner. On our way down into Great Shefford and then onto Hungerford, where we're going to have the obligatory coffee and cake stop. So that'll be nice. Not only have we got to refuel the bikes, but we've also got to refuel ourselves.
Okay then, Sandy. Well, thank you very much for your time today. It's been very interesting.
That's all right, Colin.
And I'd like to thank Martin and Gavin here at Bike Treads, our local Royal Enfield dealership, for allowing us to loan this 350 Meteor today. We've tried to show a rider's perspective of this vehicle in the sense of all the roads that we've used today and how lightweight it is. If you're out in the countryside taking photographs, just into a farmer's field entrance, do your photography, jump on and on to the next one. So light, so nimble, ideal for that.
Ideal, yeah. But it's not a motorway machine, though.
No, it's not a thrill-seeking machine. We understand that, and most people that buy this sort of thing know that. And I always think when you're buying a vehicle or anything, whether it's a tool for the garden, for the kitchen, whatever, what are you going to use it for?
Yeah, ideal garden tool.
Quite capable of a couple hundred mile journeys in a day, no problem at all there.
Easy, 300.
Set it sort of 60 mile an hour all day long if you want to do. Not that we've done that today, because we have respected the fact there's a new bike and tried to keep the speed down to about 50-ish. But we know there's plenty more there, don't we?
Yeah, there's plenty more.
Yeah. I'd like to think that Royal Enfield have progressed to this classic style, modern rideability.
Yeah, yeah.
Leaps and bounds from the Bullet and the Classic
in lots of
ways.
It's a rounded, complete package. It's a lovely bike, isn't it? They've really bought the brand into the 21st century.
Certainly,
I think.
They have. Yeah. And what I'd like to say also, in all fairness, compared to my 500 Classic, the performance is very much the same. The riding is very much the same. The handling is very much the same. But the massive improvement: no vibes on the mirrors, no vibes on the handlebars, no vibes on the footrests.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a much smoother, more comfortable bike, and I think this will appeal to the younger riders.
Yeah, yeah.
If you want the classic and you need the vibes, then the older stuff is better for that. Yeah? And I think the mindset of the older people is the 350 is the poor relation, you need the 500. Them days are gone.
This 350 engine is, I reckon it's, well, I mean, would you say it's as powerful in feel to your 500?
Very little in the difference.
Yeah.
Not enough. Because it's on paper, you see them horsepower figures.
Yeah, yeah.
But the actual riding, do you notice it? Not really.
No.
And I think what Royal Enfield have done with this bike is similar to what BMW have done with the Mini. They've really improved it. Fiat did it with the 500 as well.
Yeah, yeah.
No comparison in the two vehicles, ancient and modern.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Well done, Colin. Well, I reckon you've done a good job of presenting that there.
Hopefully we have.
I'll give you a job. I don't know if these lot on here will give you a job though.
No.
So that's it, everybody. Thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed the video, and hopefully more on the motorcycles in the future. So that's the end of this video. I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.
Bye for now.
Hey, are you going to be on that old 1919 smoke machine soon?
No.
You know, that old wreck of yours, you know? God, what a terrible thing that is.